So first of all, I want to congratulate you both because this has been something that for the last 5 years has progressively become more successful. Before we get into everything, I want to know how this even came about. Jeff, we'll start with you.
In 2014, Julia Roche wrote an article about some of the mentoring that we do and the tennis community that we built in New York. And David read the article and called me at my office.
So David, you see this article and you're like, I want it.
Yeah, no, so I said, yes, I read the article about the New York tennis community.
Right.
And in that first, so I just wrote an email saying, look, we have a similar community in London, and why don't we do a sort of Ryder Cup between the US and Europe?
The number of Europeans that have traveled here to be a part of this tournament speaks volumes. Tell me why you wanted to be a part of this.
Now, I've been part of the tournament now for 5 years, and this is the third time we're traveling to the US. And it's, you know, like to play tennis, and it's a great event. It's very competitive, and you know, we lost 2 years in a row now, so we need to get back.
I'm only speaking to the winners afterwards, so am I going to be speaking to you after?
We'll speak soon again.
And so you got Team USA versus Team Europe, and at this point there's a lot of talent on both teams. Who do you think has the advantage this year?
Well, I think being at home is a little bit easier, and given the number of Europeans they have on their team. So, yeah, I guess they're probably a little bit stronger, maybe, on paper.
Jeff?
You know, tennis is played on the court.
Right.
We'll just have to see. A bunch of us have played in this club. I've played in this club over the last 20 years, and I'm a New Yorker, so I take New York a little more seriously than playing other places. So they came to our house today.
This is your passion. This is your passion.
You know, I've played tennis a long time, mm-hmm. and, you know, helping young athletes with their careers is something that has been very important to me over the last 20 years. As a matter of fact, my first intern who worked for me actually plays on our over 35s team. He's 40 years old and now has his own hedge fund.
You got your first job essentially through Jeff. It all is intertwined.
Yeah, I mean, you know, getting your foot in the door and getting the experience early on is like makes a huge difference. And then after that, you know, if you perform well on the job, then you get more opportunities.
I grew up in Ireland, played Davis Cup for about 9 years, and then also played college tennis in the U.S.
At Harvard.
At Harvard, yeah.
There's a lot of nerds in this finance cup.
This
by
is
the way.
The nerd cup. Yeah.
That's, maybe, you know what? I think we just renamed the cup.
Speaking of Harvard, he's a titan in the finance world and a beast on the tennis court. What's up, Bill Ackman?
You didn't play tennis in college.
No, I was a rower for 4 years. Took that pretty seriously. It's a pretty overwhelming sport. I was told I had a good shot at making like a JV. I was at Harvard in tennis, and rowing was like a new thing, and I like to play tennis enough. And so I really dropped the sport for 15 years, and then it was that email from Jeff Appel and his persistence that got me back into the game.
I'm familiar with Jeff's persistence.
Yes, everyone is. I think it's just the inherent nature of people in finance. They're competitive.
Let's
right.
talk about that.
Sure.
Because that's the thing, and that's what, there are so many parallels between tennis and finance.
Okay,
and there are,
interesting.
And I feel like I'm seeing this, I'm like, okay, well, the fact that when you're out there, you are there, you have one thing in mind, and that is to win, but it's also the mental game of tennis. Mm-hmm. So
actually, so that's relevant. So you can be, in order to be a great investor, you can't just be a good analyst. You've got to have a good balanced psychology where you don't let your emotions affect your decision making.
Mm-hmm.
And I think the same thing certainly applies in tennis, there's no question. Mm-hmm. Now, interestingly, in business, I'm pretty good at not letting my emotions affect things. In tennis, I'm not as good, so that's what I'm working on.
I think there are a lot of parallels. You know, just like in tennis, you win a point, you lose a point. You win a point, you lose a point. You can't, you know, if you lose a point, you can't, you can't let it get to you and affect how you play the next point. And similarly, in running a hedge fund, you have a good day, a good week, a good month, bad day, good bad day, bad month, and you can't let the past sort of dictate how you're going to act and what you're going to do in the future.
Like in Spanish, they say déjalo.
Déjalo. What has happened has happened. Probably.
Déjalo. Yeah, yeah. Or like Teflon, right?
Teflon.
Like
yes. You gotta have. You gotta just let it slide off. And I think that training in tennis that I learned, has helped me in my career.
the caliber of tennis that we're going to be watching.
Yeah, it's actually quite good.
It really is.
Yeah.
Tell me a little bit about that, and tell me about who we're going to see on the court this weekend.
Guys like a Richie Rennenberg,
sure,
number one doubles player in the world for some time. Also, I think top 20 in singles. I mean, so there's some super talented people. He's also, what's nice is a very high quality group of people.
We're going to do a little word association. You ready?
I'm ready, yeah.
We'll start with a date, 1992.
Okay, that's when I won the U.S. Open doubles.
Fast forward just a few years, and here we are, the Finance Cup. So, next word association, Finance Cup.
Finance Cup has been a lot of fun. I've done this for 4 years. I see a lot of mostly younger people who are very good tennis players. I spend time with people like Bill Ackman, Krister Gardell, who are super passionate tennis supporters. And being someone who spent most of my life in tennis, we need people like them. And so it's great to see their passion and their enthusiasm.
Your name is Guillermo, but they call you something else.
Little Beast.
Little Beast. That's not a bad nickname to have, by the way. I like just having the word beast in a nickname.
I like it.
You like it?
Yeah.
You earned that.
I earned it, yeah.
Tell me why.
I'm a beast. That's why.
What was the highlight of your career?
Highlight of my career were, part of the team that won the Davis Cup and winning the Olympic medal for Croatia.
You won the Olympic medal. Now, are you going to win the Finance Cup? That is the question.
So I have to say I've been a part of Finance Cup since the beginnings. I played some, I was a part of some just for like wanted to see old friends, and I think it's good to just be around and connect people through tennis.
All right, I want to take you back to 2010. One of the longest matches in French Open history.
It was about a 5-hour match. There were very little breaks in the match. And it actually went 2 days. Match got suspended due to darkness the first day, so we had to come back the next day and finish up.
So fast forward to now, how did you get involved in all of this?
A friend of a friend connected me with Jeff, and Jeff said, hey, I got this thing called the Finance Cup, da 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 da. I know you're in Hawaii, but do you want to make the trip out? And I looked at my schedule, I said, yep, absolutely.
And so you were in Hawaii. When did you get in?
Thursday morning, 10-hour flight from Honolulu to Newark, red eye. Drove straight out here, had a little practice, dinner, and then crashed.
We want to welcome everyone to East Hampton, New York for the 5th Annual Finance Cup. We're thrilled to have such a great turnout of great players. Thank you, David and Krister and everyone on the European team for making the long trip. And you got a lot of countries representing, a lot of great players. We're very excited for the day, and we want to keep this going.
Looking forward to some competitive tennis and a lot of fun. And Jeff's going to teach us about honor and other things he said in various emails over the course of time. So this is what makes this event such an important event. And with that, let's have at it.
As impressive as the tennis is, so was the audience.
Probably.
Did you play tennis?
I all my life, but I was going to bring my racket here to play, and they didn't need me.
I feel like they could have used you, actually. I feel like Jeff would have liked to have played as your partner, actually. What do you think?
No, he wouldn't. He wouldn't. He wants to win. There's no way. There's no way.
I played his partner. I actually played his partner.
Who'd you play?
Krister.
Krister Gardell. Yeah, we have a big investment with Krister Gardell in Sweden.
I understand.
He told me last night, he came over for a drink, he said, I can't win this one. Because he said, you had a much better, well, I mean, by definition, I don't want to say it, but you had a great partner. You know, had another guy in there. I mean, not that he's bad. I'm not saying anybody bad, but Krista was a little downhearted. I can't win this one, you know, something like that.
Well, I think his prediction was accurate. Well, there's a lot of people here who I feel like you have connections
well,
to.
Well, I sort of do it. I know the companies, but they're all younger. They're all young guys. I mean, I'm, you know, and I sort of work. Well, I have a whole firm, but I don't have partnerships very much. But a lot of these guys, we listen. I'm sure my guys listen to them and all. They're all great guys. You know, I was talking to a bunch of them. And I play tennis all my, I still play. But this is a different game than I can play. I'm too old for it.
Wins it 10-4, the final.
Jeff, your final thought.
And we'll celebrate and we'll have a good time with our friends from Europe.
Despite the fact that everyone is here to have a good time, the caliber of tennis that we are seeing today is really impressive.
Thank you. Well, we're trying, and it's nice to win.
So I want to thank everyone for coming out tonight, this week. I want to thank David, who does a fabulous job. Sometimes we don't see totally eye to eye, but I do respect and appreciate his efforts, and I do appreciate him. I do appreciate the Europeans for coming out and making the trip. Krista, your racket's still in my apartment. Strings are broken, but they're there. And I want to thank Bill, of course. Bill, come up. A great partner, a great friend, and a great tennis mate. We spent many Sundays battling each other. I also want to thank a few people on our team. We want to give this year's MVP to Byron Talbot. Come on. Byron won his match in the 55s and the 45s and was on standby in the 35s. Byron, some people age, but you don't. Okay, well, phenomenal. We also want to call up, we can't help ourselves, but we want to invite Richie Rennerberg up because he's just a class act of tennis. And we also want to give a special thanks and to call out Mario Anchik, who just brought the tennis and the event to another level today. Mario, thank you for coming. Come on.
So I guess we have dessert. And I think this was the trophy ceremony. It's not quite the Olympics, but it's close. To Barcelona.
After another successful Finance Cup, it's back to Europe next year.